Hello, everybody. My name is Clint Shire, Manager of Account Implementation for Appalachia Group, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to this workshop, Reinventing the Travel Agent Value Proposition. A few reminders before we get started. Please make sure that you enter any questions into the bottom left-hand corner of your screen. That's where you're going to be able to ask Anna Maria, our presenter today, any questions that you have, and we'll try to answer all questions that we can before the end of today's presentation. Also, all travel agents who are attending any of our live sessions today are going to be entered into a random drawing to win 3 nights, both hotel and airfare for 2 people. So make sure that you stay attuned to that. Winners are going to be notified via the Ascend Facebook page and also via email. Your presenter today is none other than Anna Maria Adesso, Director of Marketing for Appalachia Group Vacations. Anna Maria, I am super grateful that you're here today, and we are excited to see what you have to share. So take it away.
Thank you, Clint. I'm grateful as well that you're helping me out on this amazing presentation. So welcome, everyone. I'm super, super excited to be here. As Clint said, I am the marketing director, one of the marketing directors for ALGV Vacations. And today we're going to talk about reinventing the travel agent proposition, which really is very, very exciting. So we're going to talk about a couple things. So what we've done at ALG, if I can sum this up in 2 words, we've come up with a recovery campaign. It's called Walking on Sunshine. And Walking on Sunshine is really about building confidence. It's about building confidence for you as an agent selling travel. But more importantly, it's about building up consumer confidence, getting people engaged and ready to travel again, which is what we're all looking for right now and we all want so desperately, right? So there's a couple different components of this campaign that actually this particular group is the first group of agents to hear the launch of this. We're going to be rolling this out after the Ascend conference, and you're going to see the different things we've developed. One of these is a COVID edition travel quiz. From that quiz, we're going to get some data, and we're going to help you dive into the mind of the travelers and what they're thinking. We've got another couple of secret things that we'll talk about as the presentation goes on. But finally, we're going to talk about really why 2021 really is the year of the travel advisor, and we could not be more excited. So looking forward to that. So we're going to dive into the first thing, which is our brand new recovery campaign called Walking on Sunshine. And as soon as I say that, I can't say walking out sunshine with adding the whoa, whoa, whoa at the end, right, like the song. So it just puts you in kind of that mood, right, energy, confidence. And that's what we're trying to do with this campaign. So it's a recovery campaign that we've come together to put together to help prepare for 2021 travel and really start educating people in a COVID environment, right, on how to travel. Again, confidence is key. We're really looking for confidence. Confidence for you as advisors to confidently sell these products and be very knowledgeable about it and help consumers have confidence to start traveling again and start booking. I believe Scott Wiseman gave a presentation earlier and he said we're slowly starting to see trends. And the good news is we can back that up with our own quiz data. We are also slowly starting to see trends for people embracing travel again, which is very exciting. And finally, in addition to this, we're also working with our hotel and our different destination partners to create factual and newsworthy information that then you can in turn turn to your clients, turn to your colleagues, send it out wherever. We're doing the heavy lifting for you so you don't have to, so you can focus on selling. And we're super excited about that as well. So I'm going to kick it off with the COVID travel edition quiz. And some of you might be asking another survey, another quiz, what the heck's going on with that? Well, we're going to tell you it's definitely not a survey. This is a quiz. And there's a reason we decided to go with a quiz, because people love quizzes. If you had to pick between a quiz and a survey, every time a quiz is going to win, because what do you get out of a quiz? You get some form of answer, right, a resolution as to who you are or what you think you are. So that's awesome. So super excited to announce this. Why we're doing the quiz is we're trying to extract data. And we're taking data from all different sources, which we'll talk about here in just a second. And what we're going to do is we're going to publish this data and share with our advisors monthly. So you, as well as us at Appalachia Group, we are going to be looking at this data And what we're going to then be doing is modifying and tweaking campaigns and collateral for you to help you sell as the pandemic, as the election, as so many other things going on in our environment today changes. So the goal is for us to be agile and work with you in an agile environment. It's not a one and done. It's very much alive and it will change as needed. So again, very different from what we've done. And that's why your participation and your engagement with this program is very, very critical to the success of us moving into 2021. So let's talk a little bit about this quiz. We launched it September 14th. We sent it out to the entire country via press release, right? So you can see on the left side, there's a graph that I have there, and it shows the total pickup by industry. So you can see travel and leisure is actually fourth. So that category was fourth down from the top, which was media and information. So that's amazing because that's what we want. So those are all the news sites, you know, radio, TV, all that good stuff, not to mention we had bloggers pick it up. We had a lot of financial sites pick it up as well. So lots of different people from lots of different backgrounds. So this gives you kind of a good indication of what people are thinking. We actually had 49 states return a response. So super jazzed, super excited. That's a lot of data. And it's continuing to grow and just morph into this huge thing. So we're, again, excited. Length of time to complete is 5 minutes or less, so it's quick. It's definitely not a survey. It's more of a quiz. And at the end, you get one of three results. You're either ready to travel, you're not ready to travel, or you're in the middle and on the fence. And at the end of the day, really what we're trying to accomplish and what you're going to see as we share these results with you are the pre-pandemic travel profiles. Can we gauge who these people were and how they're changing month to month to month as COVID continues, right? That's number one. Number two, we're studying their levels of risk and how their confidence is going up and down, up and down, up and down, and also sharing that with you. And then finally, we did ask them questions about the future. Now, granted, the future only being 6 months from now, but we're living in a moment-to-moment world right now. But we're trying to keep tabs on how people change as we get closer to 2021. And again, going back to crafting these types of programs that we know you need and trying to get them very quickly, very speed to market with the advisor in mind. So I'm gonna go through these next couple slides here. This is a quiz snapshot. So this is the type of data basically that we will be sharing with you. And actually this data is currently live at the end of the presentation. I will show you immediately where you can go get it and you can download this particular set of slides that we have here. So we asked them what their pre-pandemic profile was, right? So a couple of different questions here. First of all, we just asked them what type of traveler they are, basically trying to gauge frequency, how often these people are traveling. Well, the good news is that 52% of them make it a priority. So they're probably at least taking one or more trips a year versus the latter half of the group, which they'd like to travel, but they don't travel as often as they could. So let's call those folks, they travel maybe every 1 to 2 years or not as quick as possible. Then what we did was we asked people to identify with who they are as a group, right? So the largest group right here are baby boomers, no surprise, right? They're the largest group in the American population. And then it follows suit by Gen X and millennial and Gen Z. Again, having a good, well-rounded background of what these folks are doing and who they are. And then finally, we asked them what their vacation plans were for 2020, right? Basically, did you travel or did you have your travel canceled? So you can see that 41%, interestingly enough, did not plan a vacation in 2021, but 49% of them did and unfortunately was canceled by one or more different reasons. Either the person canceled it themselves or someone canceled on their behalf. So the good news is that they haven't rebooked. So what that means for advisors is there's a lot of opportunity and there's a lot of folks still trying to figure out what the heck they should be doing, what the heck, where they should go, And that's really where we kind of step in, and we're going to show you some tools on how to do that. Now, this slide is a big slide that has a lot of data on there, and we're kind of breeze through this one quickly. This was also found on our Walking on Sunshine site that you can look at later. But bottom line is consumer confidence is starting to finally show a shift towards the desire to travel. Amen. Could not be any more excited. This is what we want to see. But the question becomes really where people want to go and how far they want to travel, right? So you see here, we highlighted some key things. 62% are willing to consider it. If this were March, the number would not be nearly as high. We know it'd be way less. So that's definitely super positive, super direction, good direction to go into. And then we asked them, what's restricting the travel? You know, number one, obviously, is fear of COVID. That goes without saying. But number two was the uncertainty, right? And we're hearing that a lot, and I'm sure as advisors, you're hearing that a lot as well, that people just don't know who to believe, where to go, where can I get one single source of information that I know to be true? One of the challenges we have and one of the things we're going to talk about later in the presentation. And then if you look at the circles, those are kind of future forward questions, right? So we ask them, how do you plan a vacation in a post-COVID world, right? Like, so what are you going to do? So 49% of the folks said that they're researching travel sites, researching, not booking, also another place, you know, a huge advantage, huge opportunity. And they're taking the recommendations of friends and family, another huge opportunity, right? So this is all very conversational. And it goes back to, I have this nice little arrow showing the square and the circle like aligning together, because people on one side are saying they don't know what's safe and what's correct, but on the other side they're going to go off and they're going to start talking to people and looking for things. So again, they really are looking for someone to help them navigate. But the best news of the whole situation to date is we asked them if they feel that the pandemic is going to permanently change their own travel style, and the majority, almost 60%, said no, it's going to stay the same. So that's good. So there's a passion and a love of travel. The caveat to that is 41% said they might avoid certain locations. So that goes back to dialogue and a consumer that used to like one thing, but now, you know, we may have to sell or shift gears to another thing. And we're going to talk about how to keep that conversation going with these folks. And then finally, last statistic slide, I promise. The outcome of this particular group that we're monitoring right now, we asked point blank, are you guys ready to travel? So the good news is we only have 23% that just flat out came and say, no, we're not ready to travel. A maybe is a victory at this point, right? Because a maybe is not a yes, but it's not a no. Those are the folks that are on the fence that can't make the decision. So I go back to the other slide where it says they just don't know who to believe, who to trust, where to turn. And that's where we all come in, right? So they really need reassurance and guidance right now. And that's where I feel an advisor is just, it's your time, folks. You can seize this and you can make it your own. So it's a great time. Contrary to 2020, it is a great time. So here's my prediction. 2021, I am saying, is the year of the travel advisor. And why do I say that? Because 2020 owes you. Oh, what a miserable year it's been, right? Just a few seconds to take a quick laugh here. Some funny memes, very funny memes. Feel free to share. Feel free to send out. But it really kind of sums up the mood of everybody right now. We're all just kind of struggling. We really got beat up the first half of the year. That's why we're trying to take the second half of the year and finish strong going into 2021. So next, we're going to kind of talk about ways the Walking on Sunshine campaign can really help you as advisors. So we're going to take it back and we're going to start at the beginning. So I'm going to start this section by saying, to keep up to date on all of this information, I need you to do two things. Number one is sign up for ALGV 360. A lot of these things that I'm going to talk about will be featured in the different sections in ALGV 360. I just want to call out that if you're unfamiliar with ALGV 360 or if you haven't used ALGV 360, there's a session in the Ascend conference that you can download and listen to. So I would recommend that. And also visit VAX to sign up for your favorite brand's email. a lot of the communication with the updates, the good news, what's happening, is going to come through email. So I'm urging you to do that too. So let's break down. This is three parts, pretty easy, pretty quick. The COVID edition travel quiz, please go. It is live. It is ready. We created this quiz in mind for the advisor to help you prospect and adapt your conversations. Quizzes are light and easy. People love talking about quizzes. People love telling you what they got on a quiz. Send this out to your customers. Get your customers to pass it. Get friends of friends to pass it. The reason we're asking this is because this data that we get back will be transformed into these different digestible graphics and bits that then you can share and use in your own advertising. I just want to note that we are not taking names, addresses, phone numbers, or anything. What you see in the quiz when you take it is all we are collecting, and we are here to share. Now, the goal is to keep the quiz going until the end of the year, so every month we can show you the changes in confidence and what people are saying as we get closer to 2021. Next, super excited, custom videos. So we've partnered with Mark Murphy, travel expert. We all know Mark Murphy. We all love Mark Murphy. What we did was we sent him a camera crew and a very fancy drone down to Cancun, and he went to three different properties. He went to Dream Vista Cancun, he went to Rio Dunamar, and he also went to the Iberostar Paraiso Maya. And what he did was, from the minute he arrived at the hotel, he shot footage of how the hotels and how the destinations are helping people feel safe, their safety measures, their safety protocols. These are amazing videos. These videos are very quick, very short. They're only up to 3 minutes in length. I highly recommend checking these out. These are great for social, great for email, great for your website, but another way to get the conversation going and moving. And then finally, we're moving so quick here at ALG, but we wanted to tease this one. We have a site coming up. It's called ireporttravel.com. So going back to what the data is saying, where people are saying they don't know who to go to, where to trust, we are building this site to put the latest travel news, stories, and videos. And when I say videos, these aren't like produced videos. These are videos from people that are traveling like yourselves on FAMS right now. This is part of that 1% of folks that haven't shut down their vacation and they're going, we want people to tell the story that it's okay to travel, but you got to take some safe measures, and this is how we're going to do it. So, and we're also working with different hotels and different destinations to upload real-time footage. Amazing. So it's going to be this powerhouse of footage there. There's a huge drought right now with footage. TripAdvisor is having a huge problem with it because nobody's traveling, right? So what we're trying to do is get that user-generated content out, and that speaks volumes. This is what people want to see. This is what people ask me. I'm sure they're asking you most of the time. I wonder what Cancun looks like. I wonder what the Iberostar looks like, right? It happens all day long. So more to come. We're predicting to launch this site mid-October. Again, if you do sign up for our emails, we will be sending out updates and communications about all of these things and more. So quickly, lots of stuff here, lots of amazing things. To recap, the image you see on my screen right now, if you go to the VAX web pages for any of your favorite brands, you'll find that link. It's pretty much in the top left corner. Click on that link. Everything I just talked about, the surveys, the videos, they're all there. We walk you through, and we walk you through the coming soon things as well. Keep checking back, and we'll be updating this page regularly. So again, it goes back to please sign up for those email communications. They're critical. We'll be notifying you when new things come. In addition, I can urge you enough, please watch the recorded session if you want to learn more about ALGB 360. It's an amazing way to just maximize your marketing power. Everyone is so busy right now. We in the marketing department have done a lot of the heavy lifting for you. So please go out there, make a lot of us happy. Use a lot of that advertising that we've placed for you, and make, you know, just get the word of travel out. Get it out there. Get it out there any way we can, right? And then we're also asking, send the survey. So we've created a survey by favorite brand. You could go to this Walking on Sunshine page. You could download it. You could start sending it out today. We're urging everybody to start conversations. I started two conversations, one on my LinkedIn page, one on my Facebook page. You would not believe how many people right now are just so ready to start talking about travel, and they both kind of spiraled in a very positive way in both channels. People love the quiz and they want to talk about it, and then it just starts the conversation, and you know, anything's possible from there. And then finally, content is king. People are just so starved for content. They're so looking for content right now. Get it any way you can. We've got lots of it at ALGV, right? Lots of content, lots of it's on ALGV 360. Your friends have content. Your family have content. You have content. Start getting it out. People want to see it. People want to know. They want to see in real time, not what articles are saying or stories are saying, what is going on. So I cannot stress that enough. And we are definitely, as our Walking on Sunshine campaign moves forward, we'll have lots more content to come. Whew, Clint, I am exhausted, but lots of good stuff. So I'm going to turn it over for you for questions. Any questions? Hey, Clint, any questions? Nope. Clint? Clint, poor Clint is having technical difficulties right now, so I'm going to look to see if there actually are any questions, and unfortunately, I am not seeing any questions. So I guess we'll end it here, but thank you so much for attending. We appreciate it. If you do have questions, please reach out to your BDMs or reach out to us direct. We're more than happy to do it. You can easily address them on the Ascend social media pages too. I'm on there. I'm happy to answer anything that you guys need. We're very excited about, again, this presentation of Walking on Sunshine. It's not a campaign that's going away. It's going to be around for quite some time. So we hope you love it as much as we do. So thanks again. We appreciate your time.